there's an awful lot of outrage in this country all of a sudden, and we like to keep track of it just because it's interesting and it tells you a lot about where we're going. People are outraged about virtually everything. Sometimes they get pretty creative about getting outraged. Here's one interesting example. A restaurant patron in Phoenix, Arizona, recently complained to management about a photograph that was hanging in the restaurant of coal miners drinking after work. The patron argued that because some people might think the coal miners who are covered in coal dust, you can see the picture on the screen, were instead in blackface, it was offensive, and it should be taken down. What to make of this? Well, we decided to ask Robert Woodson. He's the president of the Woodson Center, and he joins us now. Mr. Woodson, thanks very much for coming
on. Nice to be here.
So what does this story tell us?
It tells us that race grievance is just triumphing throughout the country. That I'm upset as a civil rights person that we would spend so much time being concerned about a picture hanging of white men in coal dust, and somehow that's offensive. It reflects attention away from more critical issues facing Black America.
Exactly.
We have more Blacks killing other Blacks in 1 year than we did in the 70 years of lynchings. We have, in other words, a 9/11 every 6 months of Blacks killing Blacks, and they're going to tell me our problem is a picture hanging.
So is it possible that, let's say, you were in charge of the society or a big city, and your policies weren't helping at all, and people were still dying young and shooting each other, for example, maybe you would encourage people to be mad about irrelevant things like coal dust pictures so they wouldn't be mad at you for mismanaging their lives?
That's true, because many of those killings are occurring in cities run by Black Democrats over the past 40 years. So if politics and race were the issue, the question is, why are not Blacks succeeding?